Okay, I'm Aki Kareem for British Boxers. You know what time it is. We're in the house with Charlie Schofield. Oh. It's gone dark. It's come back on. It's fine. Minor crisis. We're in the house with Charlie Schofield, who just moved to 8-0. And of course, one of his trainers, 9-0. That's what I said. And of course, Robert Rimmer. Firstly, can you assess your performance?
Yeah. Sorry, mate. You just caught me off guard there.
Can you assess your performance?
Yeah. No. I'm happy with the win, but I was thinking about that light going off the moment. Yeah, I'm happy with the performance, like, I'm happy with the win. A little bit frustrated in some areas of it, but, you know, we'll go back to the gym and, you know, we'll work on things and we'll take him into the next fight.
Okay. Before I bring your trainer in, can I ask you, I'm going to put you on the spot a little bit.
Sorry.
It's just what I do. Can you give yourself a mark out of 10?
Off that performance then? Probably give myself about a 3.
Really?
Yeah.
What do you think then, you know, that you need to work on for next time?
Just everything really is an all-rounder, you know. But we'll go back to the drawing board and sorry.
Okay, well, from a spectator's point of view, it looked good. Obviously, you guys are seeing things we don't see. So let me just bring in your trainer, Robert Rimmer here. How do you assess the fight there?
I won't be as harsh as him and say a 3, but obviously he's a little bit hard on himself. That opponent was very awkward. Mm. He was very unorthodox, you know, he kind of tried to smother your work. But at the same time, you know, he has to start implementing stuff that he's doing in the gym, in the ring, and, you know, doing the stuff he was doing in the change rooms beforehand, nice sharp shots, and stick to textbook boxing, what he does best. And I feel like he was overextending. He wasn't in range, and that's why he was overextending, trying to throw the big shots. And that's why he's frustrated. Yeah. But he learns from it, and we go forward.
Do you see it as a learning curve, though, fighting these guys that are really awkward and hard to hit and spoiling sort of fighters?
It's a learning curve, isn't it? You know, I've gone out there, and I've not took what I've been doing in the gym. I might be self-critical here a lot, but, you know, I've not done what I've been doing in the gym or with this past training camp. You know, I feel like I have improved and just feel like I've dropped my game there a little bit on that one. But
okay, well, let's talk about some of the positive aspects then. I mean, you obviously had really nice jab, slick movement at times, really good defensively, loads of positives to look at as well.
Yeah, you know, there's a few positives. I'll watch it back. You know, tonight I'm being a bit, you know, beat myself up a little bit about it, but, you know, I'll watch it back and I'm sure there is, you know, some decent things in there. But, you know, if I kick myself on it now, you know, I'm hungry going into this next fight.
Yeah.
So I see that as a positive as well, the fact that I'm going to train harder and, you know, when I next get in that ring again, you know, there's going to be a better me in there.
Yeah, okay. Robert, what's next? What can we see next from Charlie Schofield?
Well, hopefully, like, I'm hoping to get him out on, say, in an April show. And then probably the same again, maybe a 6-rounder, even an 8-rounder. And just to try and step it up a notch now. Says, you know, it's time he's getting to that point now. It's going to be 10 fights next time. Mm. So he's got to start implementing all these things he's doing. Because, listen, he does it. I've seen it time and time over, but he's just got to do it in the ring. And he can be self-critical and whatever, but, you know, he shows that he does do some nice things. He's got a great jab. He's just got to use it more. You know, he steps off. Even when he throws his backhand, you know, he's very successful with it. But it's just about finding that range. And, you know, he knows what he's got to do. So we go back to the gym, we work on it, and we're going to the next fight confident and getting that win.
Brilliant. And just a final word on your gym as a whole, okay? So you've had a bit of a rebranding and everything like that. Tell us a little bit about that, as well as the gym as a whole.
Yeah, well, like I said, the gym's busy now, it's booming, so obviously it's got a lot of history to my gym, and it was Billy Graham's Pheonix Camp, so I've decided to obviously keep that name, as it, you know, it's a lot of history, and not only that, it's produced many, many champions, and hopefully it can do the same for me, so I've rebranded it Robert Rimmer's Pheonix Camp, which I'm sure, and I hope Billy's happy with.
Yeah. Fantastic. And final word to you, Charlie. You got anything to say to everyone that came out and supported you?
Yeah, definitely.
Things?
Just thanks for the massive support, as always. You know, you know, thanks for putting his support behind me there. That's like my trademark Instagram. You check my Instagram out, and it's just full of media and thumbs up in it all over. But no, just massive thank you to everyone for the constant support, you know, from as an amateur and all the way through this pro career so far. You know, I can't thank everybody enough for that, so.
Okay, thanks a lot. Listen, this is Charlie Schofield, 9-0. Sorry for the awkward questions as well. Sorry about that. He's moving on to bigger and better things. Watch out for this camp. You know the score. Power!